my name's Michelle. You may know me as Lab Muffin Beauty Science, or just that weirdo who really, really likes exfoliants. So that's what I'm talking about today, exfoliating.
Yay!
Why am I so obsessed with exfoliation? Well, it's one of the easiest things that you can add to your routine, and it has such big effects. When I first started getting into skincare, my skin was dull and covered in blackheads and whiteheads. My post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, which is the brown marks that stay on your skin after the pimples go away, this would take forever to fade away. Adding exfoliants changed my skin dramatically. All the stuff I'm going to be talking about today is also in my exfoliation guide, which you can download for the low, low price of $0. After you download the guide, you can unsubscribe at any time if you don't want updates, but if you want to know about new blog posts and videos right when they come out, which is about once a week, then you'll probably want to stay on the list. Either way, you'll get the exfoliation guide, which has all of this info and a whole bunch of other advice in a handy reference format, which you can also print out as well if you want. Let's talk about exfoliating. Your skin has a whole bunch of layers. The main two are the dermis, which lies below the epidermis. The epidermis is really cool. It acts as a really good barrier between your insides and the dangers of the outside world. One of the main ways it does this is by shedding dead skin cells quite quickly, so that any bacteria or microorganisms that can harm you can't really get a foothold. Your skin has an outer layer of dead skin cells, around 15 to 20 cells thick. This is called the stratum corneum, and it gets replaced around once every 2 weeks. You shouldn't even notice it coming off if everything is working properly. But sometimes it doesn't work properly. Things like aging, hormones, changes in your diet, changes in the weather, and even using the wrong skincare products can slow down your skin's natural exfoliation processes. And when this happens, you can end up with clogged pores, breakouts, rough patches, wrinkles, and dull skin. You can help your skin along by exfoliating. There are two main categories of exfoliation: physical exfoliation and chemical exfoliation. Both are great, they each have their pros and cons, and you can use them together as well. Physical exfoliation is also called manual or mechanical exfoliation. It's when you buff away dead skin cells, a bit like sanding down wood, but hopefully much, much gentler. Physical exfoliation is what most people think of when people talk about exfoliation. Things like scrubs and brushes are physical exfoliants. Physical exfoliation has a few advantages. Firstly, the results are immediate, so you can quickly see if you've exfoliated enough. It's also easy to adjust how gentle or harsh a physical exfoliant is. You just press harder or buff your skin for longer. There's also a lower chance of an unexpected reaction, because it only works on the surface of your skin. On the other hand, physical exfoliants do only work on the upper layers of your skin. It's also pretty easy to scrub too hard, and a lot of people purposely scrub too hard because it feels nice and it feels like it's working. But unfortunately, this causes irritation and over-exfoliation, which can make your skin break out and feel sensitive, so the opposite of what you want to do. Chemical exfoliation involves applying a product that helps skin cells come off more easily without directly buffing them off. Some chemical exfoliants loosen layers of dead skin cells so that they come off more easily and in smaller pieces. Sometimes they'll act as chemical messengers to change how quickly skin cells are produced, so the stratum corneum will renew itself more quickly. Chemical exfoliation has a lot of advantages. They tend to work more evenly than physical exfoliants, and it's harder to use them incorrectly. A lot of chemical exfoliants also have additional benefits on top of exfoliating too, like fading pigment and calming down inflammation. But compared to physical exfoliants, they tend to be a bit more slow to work, which means you have to be more patient when you're checking if a new product is working. There's also a higher chance of irritation and allergic reactions since they penetrate deeper into your skin. Some of them can also make your skin more sensitive to the sun's harmful UV rays. Now that we know what the two categories of exfoliants are, let's look at the most common ones. The most common physical exfoliants are probably scrubs. Scrubs can have a wide range of different scrubbing particles that vary from gentle to harsh. Some of the gentler particles in scrubs are plastic microbeads, jojoba beads, castor sugar, and ground oatmeal. Plastic microbeads generally don't break down in the environment, and they're too small to be filtered out from sewage, so it's best to avoid them so you don't contribute to plastic waste in the environment. A lot of brands are phasing them out as well, so it's very easy to find alternatives. Harsher scrubbing particles include coffee grounds, chunky sugar and salt crystals, and crushed nut kernels. I personally wouldn't recommend using these on your face unless you're quite experienced with exfoliation, because it's really easy to go too hard and end up with irritated skin. And irritation can cause breakouts and make existing breakouts even worse. But these harsher scrubs can be really good for sanding down rough patches on your body. As well as buying scrub products from the store, you can also make your own scrubs by mixing ground oatmeal, sugar, salt, or coffee grounds with oil or water. When you're using scrubs, I recommend buffing lightly in small circles for a longer time rather than going really hard for a shorter period. It tends to give you more even and thorough exfoliation without overly irritating your skin. A type of product that I really like for physical exfoliation that's similar to a scrub but isn't really a scrub is the peeling gel. Peeling gels are also called gommages. They have ingredients like cellulose or carbomers that roll up and turn into these soft scrubbing fibers when they interact with your skin. They're really gentle but really thorough for exfoliating. I really like them for getting rid of dead skin flakes without irritating your skin or taking off any bits of skin that aren't quite ready to come off yet. I really like the peeling gels from the face shop. They have one called White Jewel Peeling Gel, and that works really well. There was also a peeling gel from Skin Food that I used for a really long time called Pineapple Peeling Gel. I really liked it. It had some scrubbing grains in there as well as the peeling gel fibers, and I found that it gave me a really nice, thorough exfoliation. The packaging was a bit annoying because it was hard to get the last bits out, but overall, that was like a really minor complaint. There are also a ton of tools that you can use for physical exfoliation. Face cloths, face brushes, and contact sponges are all really good physical exfoliants. When you're using these tools, you need to make sure that they stay clean because any dead skin cells that accumulate on them will act as food for bacteria and mold. Bacteria and mold aren't good for your skin. They're going to lead to breakouts and infections. To avoid this, make sure you clean your tools after you use them and let them dry out in between using them, and also replace them regularly. I've used cleansing brushes in the past and the Foreo tool as well, and I quite liked using them, but they don't really fit well into my routine. My skin's also really sensitive when there's things like bacteria building up on beauty products and towels and stuff like that, so I'm a little bit scared of cleansing tools, but I know a lot of people who use them and they find them really good. There are a few different categories of chemical exfoliants that you can find in skincare. The most common chemical exfoliants are the hydroxy acids. In general, these work by speeding up how quickly skin cells renew themselves and loosening the layers of dead skin cells so that they come off more easily in smaller chunks. They've also been found to even out skin tone and lessen wrinkles. The most common ones are the alpha hydroxy acids, like glycolic acid, lactic acid, and mandelic acid. These are usually recommended if you've got dry skin, but I have oily skin and I found them really useful for smoothing out my skin and fading hyperpigmentation. Alpha hydroxy acids work most effectively at a lower pH, so usually products with a pH below 4 and a concentration of between 4 and 10% are recommended when you're just starting out with these AHAs. For AHAs, I really like lactic acid. There's a whole bunch of lactic acid products that you can get as well, which are really good. So for example, there's one from The Ordinary. There's one that I really like from Ultraceuticals. I also like the weaker toner style hydroxy acid exfoliants like Pixie Glow Tonic and Crave Beauty Kalaluya because you can use them more regularly without worrying about irritation, and you can use them, I guess you can incorporate them into your routine a bit more easily as well, so you don't have to worry about combining it with other irritating things because overall the irritation ends up being a bit less. If you're just starting with exfoliation, I wouldn't recommend one of the stronger wash-off AHA products yet. But if you're a bit further along and you've got quite a lot in your routine, I like having these wash-off products because then you can just insert it at some point during the week and you have more space to move your other products around. So the ones that I've tried so far are Kate Somerville's Exfolicate and Drunk Elephant's Baby Facial. And both of these seem to work pretty well. I tend to use them just before a shower. I use them like a mask and then I wash it off in the shower. Salicylic acid is often called beta hydroxy acid. And because it's more oil soluble than alpha hydroxy acids, it's often recommended for people who have oily skin and acne. There's been a study that found that pH matters a lot less for salicylic acid, and it can exfoliate effectively even around pH 7, which is neutral. I have a video, which was actually my first video, that talks more about pH and acids that I've linked in the caption if you're interested in the finer details of how all of this works. In terms of beta hydroxy acid exfoliants, I always recommend Paula's Choice 2% BHA liquid. It's got a really liquid texture, it goes on really nicely, it shrinks blackheads, and it's really good at calming down pimples as well. And it lasts forever. A newer type of hydroxy acid is the polyhydroxy acid, or PHA. This includes ingredients like lactobionic acid and gluconolactone. They're less well researched, but they're supposed to work as well as other hydroxy acids, but with less irritation. One of the problems with hydroxy acid exfoliants is that alpha hydroxy acids have been found to make your skin more sun sensitive, so it'll end up burning faster. This sensitivity isn't just when the alpha hydroxy acid is on your face, so you don't need to only use them at night, but you do need to make sure that you wear sunscreen every day when you have alpha hydroxy acids in your routine, as well as for a week after you stop using them. There are also some exfoliants that use enzymes, which can break down proteins, helping your skin exfoliate. The most common ones in skincare products are bromelain from pineapple, papain from papaya, and actinidane from kiwi fruit. These exfoliants are usually used like a mask. You put them on for around 10 minutes before you wash them off. You can DIY an enzyme exfoliant by mashing up the raw fruit and putting it on your face. Canned fruit doesn't work as well because when you can a fruit, you have to heat it up to a really high temperature, and this denatures or changes the shape of the enzymes, which means that they don't work anymore. I'm really lazy with my enzyme peels, so I usually just DIY them. If I've been eating kiwi fruit, for example, I'll just save the skins and then keep it in the fridge and rub it on my face right before I go and have a shower. How much exfoliation your skin needs depends on your skin type, skin conditions, and the rest of your skincare routine. I've put more detailed recommendations for different skin types and conditions, dry skin, oily skin, aging skin, acne-prone skin, sensitive skin, and so on, in my free exfoliation guide. But here are some general tips. When you start using exfoliants, I usually recommend that you pick one gentle exfoliant and start using it around once a week. And then, if that goes well, then start increasing how frequently you use it. So start using it twice a week, three times a week, and upwards. Then, if you still want more exfoliation, you can add a second exfoliant from a different category. So if you started with a chemical exfoliant, you would add a physical exfoliant next, or if you started on a physical exfoliant, you'd add a chemical exfoliant. You should be waiting a few weeks before you add a new product to lower the chance of your skin having a bad reaction. It also lets you see which products are actually working, which means it'll be easier on your wallet, and it'll stop your skincare routine from taking up way too much of your time. You should always start and build up your routine slowly. It's always much better to under-exfoliate than to over-exfoliate because it can take weeks for over-exfoliated skin to finally recover. When you exfoliate too much, your skin gets sensitive, tight, red, and overly shiny. If you see any of these issues start to crop up on your face, then you should stop exfoliating for at least a few days until your skin starts recovering, and then if you want to start again, start really, really slowly. Going slow is especially important when you're starting on new products, and especially if your skin is quite sensitive. Make sure you patch test new products before you put them on your whole face, so if anything goes wrong, it's much easier to hide and it'll hurt less. And that's a quick guide to exfoliation. I've put a link to my free exfoliation guide in the caption below if you want all of this info and much more in a guide that you can print out and refer to when you're working out your skincare routine. I also have more product recommendations and short reviews in there, and I've linked some products in the caption as well. If you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. You can also find out more about the science behind skincare and other beauty products on my blog, which is labmuffin.com. If you want more regular beauty tips, you can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram. See you next time for more beauty and science.